Do you want to learn how to train your own LoRA and then publish it on Remix? You could even start making money from it. I'll explain it in 3 minutes. Let's go! We are going to start with the reference images for training, and we'll need at least 10. But first, we need to be clear on what type of LoRA we want to train. Our model can focus on a character, a product, or even a style. If you want to replicate a character, I recommend that your image set includes a variety of angles and aspect ratios, close-ups, mid-sats, full-body sats, and if possible with different backgrounds and outfits. For a product, make sure to take pictures from different perspectives, showing the object in various positions. As for style, the more variety there is between the images, the better. Remember, 10 is the minimum. But the more you can include, the better the model will perform. Of course, make sure the images are of the highest quality. Avoid noisy, blurry, or low-resolution photos. Now, let's put all the images in one folder and number them starting from 1. The next step is creating captions for each one. For that, create a text file for each image with the same name. So for image 1, the file will be 1.txt. The content of these files will be a description of the image. But before you add the details, you need to select a trigger word. This word will activate your LoRA when you run a prompt. For example, I'm going to use the word mandapunk, which perfectly represents the style of the recent works I've created. Now that we have the trigger word, it's time to complete the text files. Here's an example. This is image number 1, so in the file 1.txt, we'll write a text that describes it and includes our trigger words. For example, close-up of a middle-aged man wearing a spacesuit in the style of mandapunk blurred background. Once you've completed the whole process, zip the files together in the same folder. Now we have our dataset ready, all we need to do is train our LoRA. That we head over to FAL at FAL.ai, and after selecting the Explore tab, click on Train a Flux LoRA. You'll reach this screen where you need to upload your zip file, enter the trigger word, in this case remember mandapunk, and if it is a style, toggle this switch. You don't need to change anything else, just click Start. Remember, training a model on platforms like this has an associated cost. In this case, it's $2, but trust me, it's totally worth it. You'll see why in a moment. Once your LoRA is trained, you'll see it marked as completed. Click Show Files and copy the link for the saved tensors file. We'll need it later. If you want to generate images, you can click Run Inference. Keep in mind that each generation also has a small cost. To show you that it's already working, let's try a simple prompt like a wide shot of a war elephant in the subway in the style of mandapunk, and configure the output settings like aspect ratio and number of images. Click Run, and in a few seconds, there is! Not bad, right? But the best part is still to come. We can publish our LoRA on Remix and let the whole community use it. Let's see how. Open Remix and go to any session. Click on the model selector and then click the plus button. First, paste the link we copied earlier. Remix will automatically detect what it is. You just need to fill in the following: LoRA's name, description, trigger word, upload some example images, and finally choose whether it will be free to use or only for pro versions. Keep in mind, if you choose the second option, you can start earning money the more people use your model. I've left this one for you to try it for free. Check out the awesome things you can generate with that. Now it's in your hands. Will you join the best generative AI creators community? See you on Remix, guys. Bye bye.